Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 10, Chapter 5, entitled The Meeting of Nanda Maharaj and Vasudev, verse number 27. Bhratar mama suta kaschin, matra saha bhavad vraje, tatam bhavantam manvano, bhava bhavad bhayam upalalitaha, bhratara mama suta kaschin, matra saha bhavad vraje, tatam bhavantam manvano, bhavad bhyam upalalitaha, bhratar mama suta kachin, matra saha bhavad vraje, tatam bhavantam manvano, bhavad bhyam upalalitaha. Mataji's. Bhratara, my dear brother, mama, my. Sutaha, son, Baladev born of Rohini, Kachit, weather, Matra Saha, with his mother Rohini, Bhavat Vraje, in your house, Tatam, as father, Bhavantam, unto you, Manvanaha, thinking, Bhavad Bhyam, by you and your wife, Yashoda, Upalalitaha, properly being raised. Translation by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. My son Baladev, being raised by you and your wife, Yashoda Devi, considers you his father and mother. Is he living very peacefully in your home with his real mother, Rohini? So there is no purport, we'll go to text number 28. Pumsa stri vargo vihitaha, suhrudo hi anubhavitaha, na teshu klishyamaneshu, trivargorthaya kalpate. Translation. When one's friends and relatives are properly situated, one's religion, economic development and sense gratification, as described in the Vedic literatures, are beneficial. Otherwise, if one's friends and relatives are in distress, these three cannot offer any happiness. Purport. Vasudev regretfully informed Nanda Maharaj that, although he had his wife and children, he could not properly discharge his duty of maintaining them and was therefore unhappy. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Mena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Preshthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Vancha Kalpa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindho Bhyayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna. So first of all, I seek blessings of all the Vaishnavas so that I can speak something for my purification. So today we are considering these two verses. This is verse number 27 and verse number 28. If you see it carefully, so these two verses, they are telling about some effects or the experiences what the Nanda Maharaj or the Vasudev, so they are experiencing over here. So these two verses are showing the effects. But one may ask then, what is the cause of these effects? So that Shukadeva Goswami narrates in the next shloka where Nanda Maharaj is telling to Vasudev, alas, King Kamsa killed so many of your children born of Devaki, and your one daughter, the youngest child of all, entered the heavenly planets. So now in the next verse it is telling, so what is the cause of all these two effects which are mentioned in these two shlokas? So once Narad Muni, so he went to the city of Mithila. So there he met the king of Mithila. His name was Bahulashva. So as the saintly persons come, so it is the duty of the person to ask something about Krishna Katha. So Narad Muni was also narrating the same Krishna Katha, the 10th canto. So when he was narrating Narad Muni, so he also came to this particular verse which Shukadeva Goswami is telling in verse number 27 regarding the birth of Baladev. So when Narad Muni was narrating, so during that time he told that the Krishna, he ordered Yogamaya that she has to transfer the womb of the seventh womb of embryo of Devaki from Devaki to Rohini. And Krishna telling to Yogamaya that now Rohini is in Gokul. And Krishna tells why Rohini is in Gokul, because she is fearful of one great terrorist who was in Mathura, whose name was Kamsa. So here also we see the same two effects or the experiences are coming for Vasudeva, which Nanda Maharaj is also telling. So when Bahulashva heard this, that this personality Kamsa, so he is doing so much terror and atrocities in the city of Mathura, so he becomes very curious. And he asked Narad Muni, can you kindly explain to me who is this Kamsa? So how he got all the power regarding his birth and what are these deeds? Then Narad Muni started narrating the story of this great terrorist Kamsa. So Narad Muni tells, it is during the time of the Samudra Manthan. So in the previous life, this Kamsa, he was known as a Kalanemi, and he was also a demonic in nature. And as all the Asuras, they have always wanted to fight with Vishnu, so this Kalanemi, he also wanted to fight with the Vishnu. And he rode on his vehicle. So his vehicle was very special. He rode on a lion. He rode on a lion and he just challenged Lord Vishnu. And he becomes very angry. He threw one trident towards Lord Vishnu. But Lord Vishnu, he hold this trident, and with the same trident, he threw it back. With one stroke, he killed this Kalanemi and also the lion. But the demons, they have got their spiritual master, whose name was Shukracharya. Shukracharya knew one very special vidya. So that is called as Murta Sanjeevini Vidya. Murta means the person who is dead. Sanjeevini means he can revive that person. So Shukracharya came towards the dead body of Kalanemi and he started chanting some mantras and he threw some water on the dead body of Kalanemi and he got revived. But his body was revived, but his consciousness was not revived. Again, the enmity or the animosity of this Kala Nemi towards Vishnu, it was just continued. So he also wanted to fight with Vishnu, but he could understand that he had very less power. So he also wanted a greater power. And he also thought that in his parampara, that is the Asura parampara, who was the person who became very powerful. Then he could see that Hiranyakashipu was very powerful. And how he was powerful? Because he did a great austerity. So he also decided to follow the path of the Hiranyakashipu. So he went to this Mandrachala mountain and he started doing all the austerities. And what was his austerity? He was just taking a little bit of the Durva grass juice every day. And he started doing all the austerities over there. And he did this austerities for 100 Divya Yugas. So according to the earthly calculation, this is 18,000 years. So for long 18,000 years, he did this austerity. And after 18,000 years, the Brahmaji, he became pleased and he came in front of this Kala Nemi. And he asked what boon you wanted. Now his desire was, he wanted to fight with Vishnu. So that's why he didn't ask that I should not be killed by Vishnu somehow. But he was thinking that he had the only fear of the devatas. And he asked the Brahmaji that please grant me a boon that none of the devatas should kill me. And the persons who are below the devatas, he are thinking that they are something like mosquitoes. So there is no need to ask any boon from the Brahmaji. Anyway, Brahmaji told that this is a very difficult proposal to grant you, but still you are now qualified by doing the austerities. He told, so be it. And he becomes very powerful and he becomes very proud. But by that time, his lifespan was finished. So because of that, now he has to take one more birth. But that consciousness was just continuing. So in the next birth, he born as the son of Ugrasen and his wife Padmavati. So regarding the birth of this Kamsa, Sanatan Goswami also narrates this in Bhrut Bhagavatamrut, and he cites Padma Puran, Srishti Khanda, verse number 48 to 51. In that also he narrates the story of Kamsa's birth. And it is explained that when the Ugrasen and Padmavati, they got married, so after some time, Padmavati, she went to her father's place. Her father's name was Satyaketu. So she was living in the palace of this Satyaketu. So one day, she was just roaming in the beautiful gardens of that palace. During that time, in the skyway, there was one personality who was Kubera's associate, whose name was Drumila. So he got very much attracted with the beauty of this Padmavati. So he wanted to have her, but there is no way. So because of that, he was disguised as the Ugrasen. She came to Padmavati and she had seduced her. But later she could understand that this person was Drumila, who was the associate of Kubera, but it was very late and he left that place. But during that time, there were no abortions and all those things. So she has to stay with that embryo and she delivered that boy. But as soon as she delivered that boy, generally that Matru Vatsalya, that is there, but she could not show any affection of the motherly affection for that child because she knew that this child is belongs to that Drumila and it was a very black spot in her life. So therefore she becomes very much annoyed and in fact she cursed to that boy that this boy of this Drumila, he is going to be killed by my husband's one of the clans in the future. So that was the curse. As soon as he got the birth, he got this curse by his mother only. So this Kamsa, because he didn't get the maternal affection, you can see that how can the child, he will behave. So he also, already he has got the demonic tendencies, and in the childhood also he started fighting with so many people. And he used to wrestle with so many wrestlers, and by this only he grew and he became young. So when he becomes young, so during that time in the Magadha Desh, that is the present day Bihar, so there was this Jarasandha. So Jarasandha, he also a demonic person, and he also think that he has got very powerful arms, and he wanted to conquer all the directions. He wanted to become a Digvijayi. So because of that, he was going place to place and challenging all the kings. And on the way, he came and camped at the banks of Yamuna. And when his camp was at the banks of Yamuna, so during that time, he heard one news that there was one elephant whose name was Kuvalaya Pida. So it somehow it becomes very angry, and it broke all the chains, and it just started coming out of the camp. And according to one of the shastras, it is called as Manasollasa. In this Manasollasa, there is a portion called as Gajavaiheli. According to this Gajavaiheli, it is explained that regarding the nature of the elephants, that whenever the elephant that becomes very angry, it wanted to fight. Until it fights with somebody, its anger cannot be subsided. So because it come out of the camp, it enters into the jungles, and it was just roaring like anything. So just by its thunderous roar, all the animals, they just flee. And it couldn't get any opponent just to fight with. And it is explained that it ran about 80 miles. And it came to the place where Kamsa was wrestling with the wrestlers. So as soon as the other wrestlers, they saw this Kuvalaya Pida coming, all the wrestlers, they just vacated that place and they ran away. And now here the Kamsa. So he was also very powerful, and he also wanted some virasa to be experienced. And he got this Kuvalaya Pida. So he caught hold of the trunk of this Kuvalaya Pida and threw it back. And again this Kuvalaya Pida, it becomes very angry, and it again rushed towards him. So this time he caught hold of its trunk very tightly, and he whirled him and threw this Kuvalaya Pida 80 miles away where it has come from. That is the camp of Jarasandha. So when the Kuvalaya Pida came again back to the Jarasandha's camp, so Jarasandha was annoyed, and he asked what happened. Somebody told the Kuvalaya Pida guys came back. And he didn't get angry, but he becomes astonished. He wanted to see that great personality who did this Herculean task. And later he could understand that the Kamsa, so he was a very powerful person. So now Jarasandha wanted to have a friendship with Kamsa. So just to continue with the friendship, so he told that, I have got two daughters, Asti and Prapti. So you please get married to these my daughters, Asti and Prapti. So he told, okay, so be it. He was thinking that because he was not recognized. He was just doing some net practice previously. He didn't think that he is a champion. And now somebody like the great Samrat or Emperor of Jarasandha, he was thinking that, okay, now you are the very great warrior. So that is the certificate. So he becomes very happy, the Kamsa. And later he married. And in the dowry, this Jarasandha gave this Kuvalaya Pida to the Kamsa as the dowry. So when this Kamsa, he becomes recognized by the emperor, so he was also thinking that, now I think I am a very great person, so why can't I do this Digvijaya? That means conquering all the directions. So now he thought that now the next practice is over. Now I have to appear in different tournaments. So he thought that, let me go to some national level competitions. So he come out of the lead practice and he started roaming to different places. So the first place he visited was this Mahishmati. This Mahishmati is the Maheshwar, current place in the Madhya Pradesh on the banks of Narmada. So this Mahishmati is famous for this Kartavir Arjuna. It was his capital, where there is a fight between the Jamadagni's son Parushuram, and that took place. So when this Kamsa, he came to this Mahishmati, so there was a king of this Mahishmati whose name was Mahishmati. And this Mahishmati king, he has got five sons. Their names were Chanura, Mushtika, Kuta, Shala and Toshala. They are also the big wrestlers. So now Kamsa came, but he is a very diplomatic person. So he was thinking that I can kill all these people very easily. But if I can kill, then it is of no use. What I will do, I will just defeat all these people. And when they are defeated, then they will become my servants. Then I will use their power also to conquer the other people also. So he came to the king Mahishmati and he told, or rather challenged, that I wanted to fight with you or your people. And if I win, I will become your servant. And if you win, then if I win, then you can become my servant. So they accepted. And then the five sons of this Mahishmati, they came. and the first Chanura, he rushed towards Kamsa, and Kamsa made a great sound and threw him to the ground immediately, in no time. And the next, the Mushtika came, and he rushed with the ferocious punches, but Kamsa, with one punch, he knocked him out. Then the third person, Kuta, he was rushing towards Kamsa, and Kamsa knocked him to the ground. He grabbed his feet and violently threw him in the sky. Then the Shala, he came. He was waving his arms and he was rushing towards the Kamsa. Then the Kamsa, he grabbed his arms only and pulled him down, and he dragged him on the ground. And the last brother, that is Toshala, he came and he also grabbed him and knocked him to the ground and threw him 80 miles away, this Toshala. And when this Mahishmati, he saw that this is a very great champion, so he thought that, okay, now we will have a friendship. And all these people, the five brothers, they become the servant of the Kamsa. Then Kamsa told that, okay, now I have to go for the next tournament, so please accompany me. And later, from Mahishmati, he went towards the Pravarshana. This Pravarshana is in Gujarat, so from Madhya Pradesh he came to the Gujarat. So this is the same Pravarshana Giri, or the Parvat, from where Krishna Balram, when Jarasandha set fire, they just jumped. So this is of 11 Yojana high, this Pravarshana Giri. And the name is also very interesting, Pravarshana. In this, the Varsha, that indicates the rain. Pra means the Prakrushta Rupena, that is incessant, always it is raining. That's why this is called as Pravarshana Giri. So he came over there. Why? Because there was also one champion whose name was Dvivida Gorilla. So he came and he challenged this Dvivida. And there was a fight for 20 days between Kamsa and Dvivida. And this Dvivida, it is explained in Srimad Bhagavatam that his arms were of the size of a palm trees. So that long his arms were there. Then on the 20th day, the fight was going on, and it came to the climax, and this Dvivida, he uprooted a mountain and he just threw at the Kamsa. And Kamsa also uprooted one mountain and he threw towards the Dvivida. And the both the mountains, they came together and it becomes a powder. And later, this Dvivida, he jumped in the sky, and Kamsa also chased him and pulled him to the ground. And when he came to the ground, he becomes unconscious, and the Kamsa, he jumped on the body of the Dvivida and broke all his bones. And now the Dvivida was also become the servant of the Kamsa. And later he moved towards the southern direction. He came to Rushyamukha Parvat, that is the Kishkinda, Hampi. So there he met one more demon whose name was Keshi. So this Keshi demon, as you know, he is in the horse form. So when he saw this Kamsa, he was winning like a thunder. Now Kamsa, he punched him repeatedly and subdued him. And after he becomes his servant, he mounted on this Keshi and he started his travel. And from Rushyamukha Parvat, he went towards the southern direction, and he come to the tip of India, that is the Mahendra Parvat, that is now the current day, the Kanyakumari, that area where he came. So when he came to this Mahendra Parvata, now he was very arrogant, very proud. So he uprooted this Mahendra Parvat and he lifted it, and again he placed it down. So he didn't satisfied with doing that one. So now he has become a very accomplished sportsman. If you see some batsman is there, if he is playing, so he is a very accomplished. Until and unless he does the century, he is not going to go out from the crease. So here also this person, he lifted once, but he is not satisfied. So he also made the century. He lifted and kept it down for 100 times. So when he does that one, so during that time, all the living entities which are living in that Mahendra Parvat, they become very much disturbed. But in particular, there was one person who was very much disturbed, that is Parashuram. Because Parashuram is living in Mahendra Parvat, even when Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in the South India Yatra, he went and visited Parashuram over there. So Parashuram became very angry, and he came and he met this Kamsa. So when Kamsa saw that Parashuram is coming, and he was very angry, so he knew about Parashuram. He was a Brahmana by birth, that means he has got the Brahma Teja, he can curse. And Kamsa was thinking that if I get cursed, then my mission is not accomplished. And he also knew that this personality is a Kshatriya Dveshi, that he is a hatred of Kshatriya. And if he saw that I am the Kshatriya, then he may harm me. So immediately, again, he is a very diplomatic person, the Kamsa. He paid his obeisances at the lotus feet of Parashuram. And he was telling, Parashuramji, I am not a Kshatriya, I am a demon. That is, I am not a Kshatriya, but I am a demon. He was thinking that you don't make me any harm. In one sense, it is right, because he is a demon, because in previous life also he was following the demon like the Hiranyakashipu in his parampara. So that's why he is telling that I am not the Kshatriya, I am the demon. Please forgive me. Then Parashurama, he was just thinking, I cannot curse now this person, but I have to do something to him. Then Parashurama told him that, so see, there is a one bow. This is called as Vishnu bow. This Vishnu bow is a very powerful. And he narrated how he got this bow. It is explained that there is an architect of the demons whose name was Mayadanav. This Mayadanav, once he created the Tripura, that is the three cities. One is made up of the iron, second is made up of silver, and third is made up of the gold. And so many demons, they are just residing in that one, and that used to be invisible, this Tripura. And whatever the persons they are inside, they are also invisible. And when the demons, they used to be there, so they are creating havoc for the demigods. So demigods, it become very difficult to attack the demons. So ultimately they went to Lord Shiva and requested him to do something. Then Shiva, then immediately he meditated on Lord Vishnu, and Lord Vishnu came and he gave his this bow of, that is called as Vishnu's bow. So he used that one, he shot so many arrows and he destroyed that, the Tripura. And later, once when Parushuram met Lord Shivji, so Shivji became very pleased, and he gave that Vishnu bow to the Parushurama. That's how this Parushurama got this Vishnu bow. And he now told Kamsa, see this Vishnu bow. So he saw there. So it is explained that this Vishnu bow, it was weighing about 1,000 tons. So that was the weight. And it is made up of 7 palm trees. So that is that much great, that bow was. He told that now you have to string this. You have to pull the string of this bow towards your ear, and if you are successful, then I can leave you. Now Kamsa has no any alternative. So he told, okay, I will try. So he lifted effortlessly, and he again pulled that string towards his ear. So again, he is an accomplished champion. So he did not do only for once. He did that one for again 100 times. Again, he did a second century, double century. But when he did that one, so there was a tumultuous sound. So because of that sound, there are so many stars and planets, they just fell to the earth. And also it is explained that there are 4 elephants which are just lifting this, the earth mandal. These 4 elephants are Rishabh, Pushkarachud, Vaman and Aparajit. So they become started trembling, and all the whole of the Bhumandal, it started trembling. And after doing that one, then Kamsa kept that bow just beside the Parushuram. Now Parushuram was very pleased. But then Parushuram told that, okay, now I will give you this bow to you, and I will give you one thing. He told to Kamsa that the person who breaks the string of this bow, he is going to break the string of your life. He told to the Kamsa. That means indirectly is indicating that in future, the Krishna is going to come and he is going to kill you. And after that, he went to a seashore. And at the seashore, he met with another personality whose name was Aghasur. You know Aghasur, he was in the form of a gigantic python. And he was licking his tongue and he was hissing towards Kamsa when he came. And it is always the nature of the snake. If somebody comes, it wanted to bite. So it also bit the Kamsa. But Kamsa, it didn't harm anything to the Kamsa. Now Kamsa becomes very angry and he jumped on the body of this python, that is the Aghasur, and he squeezed his neck, and thus he conquered this Aghasur. And from south he started going towards east, and in the eastern direction he came, so there was this great bull demon whose name was Arishtasur. So now there is a fight between Arishtasur and the Kamsa. So both of them, they are fighting like a big elephants. And after some time, this Arishtasur, it becomes very angry. If you see, when the bull becomes very angry, it uses its horns. So with these horns, it also uprooted one mountain and threw at the Kamsa. But Kamsa, he again threw it back to this Arishtasur, and with a single punch, he made unconscious of this Arishtasur. And later, after conquering this Arishtasur, he went towards again north. Now he came to Assam. So during that time, this province of Assam, this is called as Prag-Jyotishpur. So this Prag-Jyotishpur, there was this demon whose name was Narakasur. So although this Kamsa, he was a very great champion, but his glories were unheard by so many people because this is the far northeastern area. So when he came towards Narakasur and he told that, now I am challenging you and we have to fight. Then this Narakasur, he was thinking that, why I have to fight? I have got so many associates, so one of my associate will kill this person. So that's what he was telling. It is something like he wanted to be at the pavilion and he wanted to send one by one batsman so that they can play with this Kamsa. So first he sent his first batsman, whose name was Pralambasur. He was the general of this Narakasur. So during that time also the Kshatriyas, they have got some codes of conduct. So they used to fight, but they are not fighting inside the city. They used to go outside the city and they used to fight. So similarly here, Pralambasur and the Kamsa, they came out of this Prag-Jyotishpur city wall and there they started the fighting. And Kamsa again, he grabbed him immediately and threw him to the ground. And he was not satisfied. He took the body of this Pralambasur and threw him into the city so that everybody in the city could understand that he is the victorious. And here the Narakasur, he was seeing that his first batsman was out and now he wanted to send the second one. Now the second was the Dhenukasur. So he came, and Dhenukasur, when he came, then Kamsa grabbed hold of him angrily and threw him to 800 miles. And again he came back. As soon as he came back, he jumped up and he stood on the body and crushed him. Like nowadays you see WWF. So it was like the original WWF wrestling matches. And now Narakasur saw that his second wicket also gone. Now he sent the third one. He just ordered the third person. He was the Trunavarta. The Trunavarta was the hurricane demon. So he took, because he got that Siddhi, he took this Kamsa up in the sky. They traveled around 800,000 miles up. So when they went there, it is explained that this Kamsa, he has also got some mystic powers. So you used this Garima Siddhi, he also become heavy, very heavy. Like when Krishna was taken by Trunavarta, he also become heavy. So his mama, that is Kamsa, he also becomes very heavy, so that he came down immediately. And as soon as he came down, he started vomiting blood. And now Narakasur, he thought that now I have to send one more person. Now the Bakasur came. So the Bakasur, he was very powerful duck. And he wanted to try to swallow this Kamsa, but Kamsa was not allowing him. And Kamsa gave one big punch, and it was like a thunderbolt. And this white-winged demon, he went aside. Then he increased his size, his beak, and somehow he swallowed this Kamsa, and Kamsa entered the stomach of this Bakasur. And now Kamsa becomes very angry. When the person becomes very angry, the body heat, it started increasing. So he becomes like a thunderbolt. And now the Bakasur could not take the heat of this Kamsa, he spat immediately. So Kamsa came out immediately. So as soon as Kamsa came, he again caught hold of this Bakasur, whirled him around and dragged on the ground. And when all these four batsmen, they are out, so later there was one more demon, or rather the demoness, who was the sister of Bakasur, she came, Putana. And she was telling Kamsa that, now you have to fight with me. Then actually this Kamsa, he was a very accomplished warrior. So it is not a dignified thing that he has to fight with any woman. So that's why he was telling that, no, there is no need that I have to fight with you. Already I have defeated your brother, and he now becomes my friend, or rather he becomes my brother. And you are his sister, so you are also my, like my sister. That's why with all these goody-goody words, he just told Bhutala that there is no need that where to fight. And now this Narakasur, who is the captain of the team, he was in the pavilion and he was seeing that so many batsmen, they are going one by one, they are becoming out. And later he saw that now there is no way that he has to surrender to. He could understand what is the strength of the Kamsa, so he did not fight. So he came down and he surrendered to Kamsa. And later this Kamsa, now he again continued his journey. He came to the place where the Shambarasur, the demon who was living. So during this time, so many people, they could understand what are the glories of this Kamsa. So this Chambarasur also knew how much powerful this Kamsa was. So he did not fight with the Kamsa. So he just agreed to his friendship. And after this, the Kamsa went to the Trikut Parvat. He went to the summit of the Trikut Parvat, where he saw this one more demon whose name was Vyomasur. So this Vyomasur, he was sleeping over there. If you see, if some person is sleeping, if you just waking him up, what will happen? He becomes very angry. So when Kamsa went there, he didn't wake him up gently. He just kicked him very hardly. Once he was, his sleep was also gone, and he got the great punch by this Kamsa also. So he becomes very angry. And there was a very furious fist fight between both of them. And later, Kamsa, he weakened this Vyomasura like anything and made him dizzy. And later, Vyomasura also surrendered to the Kamsa. So by this time, the glories of this Kamsa was spread all over the India. So he almost become a national champion. But if you see, if some great player is there and he wanted to show his play, but there was no any opponent, so he is not satisfied with that one. So wherever he used to go, the people, they used to surrender, they used to give all the money. So that was okay. They are telling that you are the winner, but he was not happy because he is a champion. He wanted to fight, and he was not getting the opportunity. So one day on the way, he met Narada Muni, and he bowed to Narada Muni and asked Narada Muni that since so long I am not cherishing this Viriras, so please tell me, is there any person with whom I can fight? Now Narada Muni knew that how to tackle this thing. So he knew that this person is an asura, and he told him that now you have to go to one more asura. He told that there is one person at Shonitpur, his name was Banasur. So why can't you go over there and you can fight with that person? So this Shonitpur, actually in Sanskrit, the Shonit means blood. So when Kamsa entered the city of this Shonitpur, he did not see any blood, but still the name is like Shonitpur. Why it is called as Shonitpur? Because the mentality of Banasur is always to fight and all those things, bloodshed. So because of that, the name of this Banasur capital was called as Shonitpur. So Kamsa came over there and he challenged this Banasur. So who is this Banasur? This Banasur is also a very powerful personality. So Prahlad Maharaj, he has got a son whose name was Virochan. And Virochan's son was Bali Maharaj. And Bali Maharaj has got 100 powerful sons. So the eldest son of this Bali Maharaj is this Banasur. So in his parampara, he is coming from the Vaishnav parampara. Like Bali Maharaj, he is a great Mahajan. Prahlad Maharaj, he is also a great Mahajan. But this person, because of the bad association, so he did not become a Vaishnava, but rather he became a Shaivite. And he pleased Lord Shiva like anything. And when Lord Shiva pleased him, he gave one linga. And gave this linga to Banasur, and he told him that this linga will be named after you. That's why that linga is called as Banalinga. And Shiva was so pleased, he asked that, okay, ask any boon. Then Banasur told that, okay, now you become the rakshak or the protector of my this city. Then Shiva told, okay. So here this Kamsa, he came to this Banasur, and when he challenged. And this Banasur, he was also very powerful and very proud. So when he heard the voice of this Kamsa, he becomes very furious. And with a great anger, he just kicked the ground. So it is explained that the kick was so forceful, his foot went up to the Patal Loka, up to so down. And because of that, the subterranean lokas, there was a devastation. And even the great mountains, they started falling apart. And again, this Diggajas, the four elephants, they also very much perturbed. And later the Banasur told that, okay, now you wanted to challenge, so you just pull my leg outside and make it as before. If you can do that one, then I will consider that I am defeated. So now Kamsa came, and it is explained that like any some small child, he just lift some lotus from the lotus pond, he just lifted that, the foot of this Banasura. But somehow this Banasura again becomes very angry with this person and he wanted to fight. Then during that time, Shiva came and he told Banasura that if you are wanted to fight with him, then there is no use because he is destined to kill by the hands of Lord Krishna because that is the boon he got from Parashurama. So there is no use that you are going to fight with this demon. So please just surrender. And Lord Shiva, he made friendship between the Banasura and the Kamsa. And later Kamsa, from there he went to one more place where this Vatsasura was there. He was a calf demon. He was in the garb of a calf and he used to allure people. People are thinking that it is a calf, but he used to make all the atrocities. And later the Kamsa also, there was a fight. And he, in the fight, he grabbed the tail of this Vatsasura and threw him on the ground, and he conquered this Vatsasura also. So by this time, this Kamsa, he became a national champion. So any national champion, he thought that he is a national champion. Now he wanted the higher prospectus. So what he will do, he wanted to become an international champion. So now Kamsa was also thinking that now I conquered almost all of this, our nation, now I have to go abroad now. So he was thinking. So he planned that he wanted to go to abroad. So he went to this Mlecha Desha. That is where the Yavanas, the barbarians were living. So there this barbarian king, whose name was Kala Yavan, so he was living over there. So regarding the birth of this Kala Yavan, it is also explained in Vishnu Puran. The Gargacharya, he is a priest of this Yadavas. So once he visited Dwarka. So when Gargacharya visited the Dwarka, during that time his brother-in-law, the Gargacharya's brother-in-law, he ridiculed this Gargacharya anything. So when the Yadavas heard this, so they becomes very, they are just taunting again to Gargacharya that, see, your brother-in-law is telling like this. So the Gargacharya, he could not take this insult of this Yadavas. So he becomes angry. He came out and he did so much austerities to please Lord Shiva, and later by the power whatever he got from Lord Shiva, later he met one Yavana soldier. This Yavana soldier has a wife, but they don't have any issues. So in the wife of this Yavana soldier, he produced one child who was this Kala Yavan. So this Kala Yavan, he has got the Brahmanical Teja of this Gargacharya and also the warrior blood from the mother side. So you can see that how much fearful this warrior was. And now Kamsa came over there, and Kamsa has also got one maize. This maize was very amazing. It has weighing around 1,000 tons. And he called him that now we will have a maize fight. And both were just fighting. And it is explained that when, after some time, both of the mazes, they become powders. And later, this Kamsa, he jumped up and on the body of this Kala Yavan, and he was almost dead during that time, this Kala Yavan. But immediately what happens, the army of Kala Yavan, it attacked on the Kamsa. So he again left this Kala Yavan and he took another maze and he started killing all the Yavana soldiers. So when Kala Yavan saw that this person is very powerful, he also surrendered to this Kamsa. So by this deed, he become an international champion. So because he is Asura, he is not satisfied only just by becoming the international champion. Now he wanted to become interplanetary champion. So he collected all the demons and then he told that now we have to go to Amaravati, that is Indra's capital. So he came over there and all the demons, they attacked the Amaravati. And Indra could understand that these people have come, so he becomes very angry. And he started using his divine weapons towards this Kamsa. And the effulgence of this divine weapon, divine weapon was so much that it was almost blinding the Kamsa. But somehow he could manage that one. And later, this Indra threw his thunderbolt. So this thunderbolt, when it comes, it also produces so many electrical streams. So just because of the shock only, the person will die. But here this Kamsa, he is very powerful. So he counteracted that with his maze. And later Indra attacked with the sword and he hit on the head of the Kamsa. But somehow Kamsa, he just dizzied for some time, but he could manage that one. And later Kamsa took a maze made up of ashtadhatus, eight elements. That is made up of gold, silver, copper, brass, tin, lead, iron and steel. Like our panchatattva deities, they are also made of this ashtadhatu. And he threw towards the Indra. And now Indra was thinking that it is waste of time to fight with this Indra. So let us see with the other demons. So he ordered his charioteer Matali, now you take me to this other demons who are fighting over there. So he came over there and he created the havoc amongst these all the demons. And when Kamsa saw that, he again came to Indra and hit him with his iron club. So because of that, for a momentary time, this Indra, he becomes unconscious. And during that time, the Marutas, the 49 Marutas, they came to rescue this Indra. And when the generals of this Kamsa, they saw that these people are protecting the body of Indra, then Banasur, he came, he has got the 1,000 arms, and he started showering the power, the arrows, so many. So because of that, all the Marutas, they also went away. And later on Banasur, the other Devatas, the Ashtavasu, 11 Rudras, 12 Adityas, and Ribhus, they attacked. And later, this Pralambasur and the Narakasur, they came, and they are roaring like anything. So they created a different mystical type of sound vibration. So because of that, the Devatas, they started quivering. And after some time, Indra got conscious, and he mounted on the Airavat, and he pushed his goad, that Ankush, on the Airavat. And it is explained that there are so many different paintings on the Airavat, which are made up of the musk and the kumkum, sindur and the gomutra. Why they made these paintings? Because just by applying these materials on the body of the elephant becomes very much agitated. During those times, they used to use all these things. So now the Kamsa, he first hit the Airavat with the first punch, and the second punch he gave to the Indra, and Indra fell far away. And now Airavat becomes very angry. And he took Kamsa in the tusk and he threw him for 800,000 miles. So he went over there and he again came back. But he is an accomplished champion, so he could not leave that battlefield. Now he becomes very angry. And now he broke the tusk of that Airavat. And when the tusks were removed, it becomes very painful for the Airavat. He went back into the city of the Amaravati. And now Kamsa, now he thought that now I have to come to the climax of this one, because this is taking a lot of time. So he used the Vishnu bow given by the Parushuram, and he started throwing so many arrows. Because of that, all the Devatas, including Indra, they just went away from the battlefield. And ultimately, he got hold of this throne and the umbrella of this Indra. And after becoming victorious, he came back to the Mathura. So by this time, now he is a very accomplished champion, everything. But still, he is not the captain of his own team. So again, there was one incident which occurs so that he can become the captain of the Mathura. So this is the same incident we are reading here, that Devaki and Vasudev, their marriage was going on, and Kamsa was on the chariot. And later, there was Akashvani. They told that the eighth child of the Devaki is going to kill Kamsa. So he becomes very angry, and he wanted to about to kill Devaki. So during that time, the news was spread, and Ugrasena could understand. Now he is a king, he has to protect the Devaki, and he sent his soldiers to attack on the Kamsa. But Kamsa, he has also got his own big army. And also it is explained that Jarasandh also gave some army to this Kamsa during that time. He has got 8 lakh charioteers, 8 lakh elephants, and 32 lakhs of soldiers. They counter-attacked this Ugrasena's army, and it is explained that in a few moments there are around 10,000 people there died. And this Kamsa, he used his maze to kill all the people, and later he went inside and he took Ugrasena out of the throne and he sat on the throne of the Mathura. And when the other Yadavas, they could understand now Kamsa has become the king, so they started fleeing out of this Mathura and they took shelter of the neighboring different states over there. So this is the thing, that how this Kamsa, he made so many atrocities. That's why the only the two effects of that one here the Vasudev is telling, because of that he could not save his sons also. And now he is asking that how is my Balram in the Gokul. So that's why, so this is the history behind that, why the Nanda Maharaj is asking this one. So we'll stop here. Srila Prabhupada ki, Granth Raj Srimad Bhagavatam ki. Jai.